Welcome to the Climate Water Outlook for April to June 2019. Most places have had a hot and dry start to the year. However, some areas had heavy rains in March, particularly parts of the East Coast and places affected by tropical cyclones. The outlook is warmer than average for many areas, with an average or later than average autumn break for the southern cropping season likely. First, let's look at recent conditions. Much of March was drier than average for most of Australia. Severe tropical cyclone Trevor then brought rain to both Queensland and the Northern Territory, while severe tropical cyclone Veronica set a new March record for Port Hedland with 179.4 millimetres on the 24th of March. Following the hottest summer on record, March was also much warmer than average, resulting in the hottest start to the year for Australia. Rabbit Flat, northwest of Alice Springs, reached 39 degrees every day for 115 days in a row, starting in December and ending in March, a new Australian record. With the high temperatures and mostly low rainfall totals, evaporation has led to dry soils in many places. Soils in northern Queensland benefited from heavy rains in February and March, while rains in southeast Queensland have had little impact. Serious and severe rainfall deficiencies continue for many other eastern and inland parts of the country. Dry and warm conditions in March extended the southern fire season, particularly in Victoria, where several major fires occurred later than usual. Water storage levels in southeast Australia continue to fall and are well down from this time last year. Total water storage in the northern Murray-Darling Basin is nearly down to 8%, which is lower than we saw during the Millennium Drought. Many towns have had to switch to emergency water supplies, and many farmers are going another season without crops. So what's driving our climate right now? Currently, all the major climate drivers are neutral. But in the tropical Pacific, ocean temperatures touched on El Niño thresholds this month. However, we're still waiting to see if the atmosphere responds. The Bureau's ENSO outlook is now at El Niño alert. This means there's about a 70% chance of El Niño developing in 2019. Around triple the normal risk. Turning to the outlooks, with the climate drivers neutral, the April to June outlook shows no strong tendency towards significantly wetter or drier conditions across much of the country. Timing for the autumn break rainfall in southern Australia is likely to be average or later than average. But if El Niño does develop, this outlook could change rapidly, reducing the chance of above average rainfall for drought-affected areas. Keep an eye on the Bureau El Niño updates. Looking at stream flows from March to May, low flows for this time of year are likely at more than three quarters of locations across Australia. The likely near median and high flows are scattered mostly in the east. In terms of temperatures, dry soils inland mean April to June days and nights are likely to be warmer than average. So in summary, there is no strong indication of significantly wetter or drier conditions in the coming months. However, the timing of the autumn break in southern Australia may well be average or later than usual. Temperatures are likely to be warmer than average, and low stream flows are likely at most locations. For more details, visit bomb.gov.au/climate/ahead. Our first look at likely conditions from May to July will be available on Thursday, the 11th of April. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Paul Fakemer.